Hello! In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to install the SideFX Labs toolset. SideFX Labs is a completely free, open source toolset geared towards assisting Houdini users with a variety of tasks commonly used for digital content creation. It's an all-inclusive toolset that spans a shelf, digital assets, custom desktops, scripts, and more. The toolset originates from the Game Development Toolset, which got a relaunch during the Houdini 18 release. SideFX Labs is only available for Houdini 18 and newer. There are a couple of ways of installing SideFX Labs. The most convenient and recommended way is using the built-in updater inside of Houdini. So what we have here is a fresh copy of Houdini. I haven't done anything with it to modify the environment. This is just stock Houdini once you first open it. So to enable the SideFX Labs shelf, we need to click this little plus here, go to Shelves, and scroll down to find SideFX Labs. Once we enable this, we will have our SideFX Labs shelf, but we see we don't have any tools yet except for this little button that says Update Toolset. Once we click this little button, we will be prompted with the following window. This window shows us our currently installed version and the version that we can update to. By default, you of course won't have any SideFX Labs version installed yet, so this will just say none. New with SideFX Labs is that we now also ship a local copy of the toolset with every single Houdini build. So by default, it will prompt you to install the local build of the toolset. Every new daily build of Houdini will have an updated version of the toolset included with it, and this will be a production build. If we do not want a production build, we can untick this box here, and we will be provided with all the newest versions of the toolset that we have released on a daily basis. Non-production builds contain all the newest tools that we release, and production builds, of course, do not. So this is a more production-oriented build, while this one focuses on the brand new cutting-edge versions of the toolset. For now, we will just install the local version of the toolset, which, since it is shipped with Houdini, does not require an active internet connection. To install it, we simply click Update, and we wait for Houdini to install the toolset. Once that is complete, we will be prompted with this window. We just hit OK, and we now need to restart Houdini to receive the installed toolset. Once Houdini has started, and we click on the SideFX Labs shelf again, we will see that we now have a couple of tools listed here on the shelf. These are the most used tools, so we place them there for your convenience. However, to get access to the rest of the tools, you simply go into your network editor, either right-click or tab, and we will have this Labs entry here in the submenu, which will show us the Labs tools on object level. To get access to the most used subtools, we create a geometry container, and once again, we also have our Labs submenu, which will have the rest of the tools. Of course, if you're in a different context, like ROPs, COPs, and so forth, you will also have a Labs context there, if the tools are there, of course. In this part of the tutorial, I'm going to show you an alternative way to install SideFX Labs, which is the manual approach of updating. So, on this page, we will be using method to manually download from GitHub. So, the first thing we need to do is scroll all the way to the top in the SideFX Labs repository, and then if we want a brand new development version of the toolset, we can click this green button that says clone or download. We can download the zip. We can use something like source control to download this Labs. Or if we want a specific release, we can click on this releases tab and then download any of the included assets under a release. And we can see here, if it says pre-release, it's a development build. And if it says release, it is going to be a production build. So once we have downloaded that zip file, we extract it to a location on our disk. I have decided to install it or extract it in C, Labs install, and then inside of this folder, which says SideFX Labs development, which is just the name of the zip file. Inside of that, after extracting, of course, we will have all the tools, scripts, and so forth that ship with SideFX Labs, including this file here at the bottom, which says sidefxlabs.json. The next thing we need to do is modify this JSON file using any text editor, and then copy the path where we have extracted our files to, and put that inside of the text file. So under the path variable, between the quotes, I'm going to paste that path that I extracted my files to, and just change these slashes to be facing to the right. Then under the path variable, we also need to modify the value variable. And then note how I paste that same location in this variable, but I'm keeping the last part, which says slash bin. This is important to do because otherwise we will not be getting of the HDK nodes that ship with labs, such as instant meshes, substance, and so forth. Once we've done that, we just save the file, we close our text editor, and then we're going to take this JSON file, and we will be going to our Houdini 18 directory, home directory, which under Windows is located in Documents in Houdini 18. Next up, if we don't have a packages folder yet, we're going to create one. So I'm just going to click new folder and then name that folder packages. Dive inside, and then we're going to paste that modified JSON file, which will point to the extracted zip file that we just downloaded from GitHub. Next up, we can now close any open Houdini session that we have and open up a new version of Houdini so that we now have the latest installed tools. Once Houdini has opened and we click on the SideFX Labs shelf, which once again we can find under the little plus icon, shelves, and then SideFX Labs, we will now see that we have our tools installed on the shelf, but also inside of the network editor. And if we decide to click update toolset, we can see that it does indeed show us the version that we just installed. If we compare that with our JSON file that we just copied, we can see that this indeed does say 276, which corresponds to what we see here. If we want to update our toolset using the automated updater after a while, we can of course always do that. This will just overwrite whatever version you already have locally on disk.